Hello students, the topic is simple curves, method of curve ranging. There are a number of different methods by which a center line can be set out, all of which can be summarized in two categories. The first one is traditional method, which involve working along the center line itself using the strides, intersection points and tangent points of reference. The equipment used for these methods include tapes and theodolites or total stations. Second one, coordinate methods, which use control networks as reference. These networks take the form of control points located on site some distance away from the center line. For this method, theodolites, total stations or GPS receivers can be used. The methods of setting out curves may be divided into two classes according to the instrument employed. First one is linear or chain and tape method. Second one, angular or instrument method. Here some important points are comes. The peg interval. What is peg interval means? Usual practice, the peg interval fix pegs at equal interval on the curve, 20 meter to 30 meter. Strictly speaking, this interval must be measured as the arc intercept between them. However, it is necessarily measured along the chord. The curve consists of a series of chords rather than arcs. Along the arc, it is practically not possible that is y measured along the chord. Peg interval, for difference in arc and chord to be negligible, length of chord not greater than r by 20 of curve. The r means r is the radius of curve. Length of unit chord is equal to 30 meter for flat curve, 20 meter for sharp curve, 10 meter for very sharp curve. Location of tangent points. To locate T1 and T2 tangent points, the following procedure we are going to follow. First point is fix the direction of tangents, produce them so as to meet at point B. Next point, set up the theodolite at point B and measure T1, B, T2 and measure this interior angle. The deflection angle pi is equal to 180 degree minus I. Then we are getting this angle pi. Next, third point, calculate tangent's length by using trigonometric formula. How you are going to calculate? BT1 is equal to BT2 is equal to r tan pi by 2. Next, fourth point, locate T1 and T2 points by measuring the tangent length backward and forward along tangent lines AB and BC. For practically execute this method, we are following this procedure. Let us see. After locating the positions of the tangent points T1 and T2, their changes may be determined. The change of T1 is obtained by subtracting the tangent length from the known change of the intersection point B, and the change of T2 is found by adding the length of curve to the change of T1. Then the pegs are fixed at equal intervals on the curve. The interval between pegs is usually 30 meter or one chain length. The distances along the center line of the curve are continuously measured from the point of beginning of the line up to the end. The pegs along the center line of the work should be at equal interval from the beginning of the line up to the end. There should be no break in the regular of their spacing in passing from a tangent to a curve or from a curve to the tangent. For this reason, the first peg on the curve is fixed at such a distance from the first tangent point T1 that its change becomes the whole number of chains, the whole number of peg interval. The length of the first subchord is thus less than the peg interval, and it is called a subchord. Similarly, there will be a subchord at the end of the curve. Thus, a curve usually consists of two subchords and a number of full chords. Okay, thank you.